In this segment, we're going to look at another example of truncation error. In the other examples, we mentioned how truncation error is basically about approximating mathematical procedures. So let's look at another example to see that why truncation error is created. So for example, if somebody tells you to integrate a function from 3 to 9 x squared dx, and you can use your integral calculus background to be able to do this, you'll say this is equal to x cubed divided by 3, and the lower limit of integration is 3, upper limit is 9. So we get 9 cubed minus 3 cubed divided by 3, and that turns out to be a number equal to 234. And so that's the exact value which we're going to get. Now, if you remember your integral calculus, this particular integral is equal to this, means that you have basically drawn infinite amount of rectangles or trapezoids, depending on how you're looking at the area of the curve, to be able to get this number of 234. So, for example, if we had x squared, the example which we have here is x squared going from 3 to 9, what you're basically doing is this particular thing here means that you have drawn infinite number of trapezoids going from 3 to 9. And the area under the curve, which you are getting because of those infinite trapezoids which you have now, is giving you a value of 234. If you take a finite number of these trapezoids, you're not going to get a value of 234. So in numerical methods, what we have to do is we have to approximate the number of trapezoids or rectangles which we might draw from, let's suppose in this case from 3 to 9, to be able to figure out an approximate value of the integral. So let's go ahead and look at what would that approximate number be if we were going to approximate the number of rectangles which we're going to draw from 3 to 9. So let's look at the same graph here. So we got x squared here. We got x here. This is 3, and this is 9. And what we might do is, let's suppose we take the midpoint here. So we got 3 here, 9 here, midpoint here would be 6. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a rectangle from the value of the function at 3. So I would take the height to be the value of the function at 3. Then I'll draw another rectangle, which will be determined by the height at the value of the function at 6, and draw those two rectangles. So I have this one rectangle, then I have this as the other rectangle. And so this is what I'm going to use to approximate the area of the curve from 3 to 9. So you can very well see here that there is some error associated with the area which I'm going to be calculating going from 3 to 9, because I'm not accounting for this part and I'm not accounting for this part. Now, if I was going to draw infinite such rectangles going from 3 to 9, I would get the exact value, which is 234. But as you know, in numerical methods or in real practice, you cannot afford to draw infinite rectangles, because then you'll be there forever calculating the area of infinite rectangles. So you got to draw a finite number of rectangles from 3 to 9. And this thing is called LRAM, which is the left-hand side Riemann sum, which you might have talked about in your integral calculus class. So let's go and calculate how much the area under the curve here is. So the area under the curve from 3 to 9 of this function x squared will be approximately now equal to the area of rectangle number 1. So let me call this 1. I'll call this 2. So it will be area 1 plus area 2. Now, the area 1 which I'm going to get will be x squared, the value at x equal to 3, times 6 minus 3, because that's the height of the rectangle at x equal to 3, and that is the width of the rectangle. Plus, if you look at the second area, which is this area right here, you will get x squared, the value at x equal to 6, and 9 minus 6, because that's the width of the rectangle. So this number here gives me 3 squared times 3 plus 6 squared times 3. And this number here turns out to be equal to 135. So that is the approximate value of the integral which you are getting by drawing two rectangles, one going from 3 to 6, with the height being the value of the function at 3, and the second one being the rectangle which is drawn from x equal to 6 to x equal to 9, with the height being the value of the function at x equal to 6. So that's the approximate value of the integral. So your truncation error will be equal to the exact value, which is 234 minus 135, and that's a truncation error of 99 units, which you are getting between the exact value and the approximate value. So I'm going to leave you with an exercise. I'll ask you to go ahead and do this exercise to see that whether you get less amount of truncation error by doing as follows. In the previous case, what we did was we drew two rectangles going from 3 to 9. So what I'll do is I'll ask you to maybe draw four rectangles. So now we have this midpoint 6, midpoint between here is 4.5, and this is 7.5. So you basically draw one rectangle here, then you draw another rectangle there, then you draw another rectangle there, and then you draw another rectangle there. So now you can see just graphically that you are using more of the area under the curve from 3 to 9, and most probably you're going to get a better estimate of the area of the area under the curve. So go ahead and find out from 3 to 9, if I have x squared dx, what is this approximately equal to if I draw four rectangles like that. In fact, you can write a program. Maybe you should also, so this is first exercise which I'm asking you to do. Second is maybe write a program to simulate finding the area under the curve. So in this case, you would write a function, maybe which is called area. And the inputs in this case will be the function itself, in this case x squared, the lower limit of integration, the upper limit of integration, and then the number of points which you're going to choose from 3 to 9. Or maybe n will be the number of segments you're going to choose from 3 to 9 in this case. So for example, in this case, the function, as an example, the function would be x squared, a is 3, b is 9, and n is 4. So when you write your program, go ahead and check whether the number that you're getting from the program is same as what you get by doing the same problem by hand. And then you can keep on increasing the value of n and see there whether it comes close to the exact value of 234. And that's the end of this segment.